I am finally here with a tutorial on how I got my new mint green hair. Now, I am obviously wearing extensions in my hair at the moment, so I'll just stand up so you guys can see. They have quite a few different colours in them and different tones and all that jazz. So I will link the tutorial for how to colour your extensions, basically just tips and tricks on colouring your extensions and also how I got mine this colour in the description box below. It will be over on Irresistible Me's YouTube channel. So if you want to know how to do that, then go over there and check it out. But today's video is basically going to be on how I got my kind of mint pastel green hair. So I've got a lot of comments on this and a lot of people loving it. So I wanted to share with you guys how I got this color. All right, so first things first, if you're wanting to get your hair similar color to what I have, well, obviously you would, because why would you be watching this video? you will need to have blonde hair first. The lighter the hair, the more pastel and true the color is going to turn out. If your hair is orange or brown or black, it's not going to work. You need to have blonde hair if you want to get this result. I'm going to list in the description box below a few videos, like from going black to blonde, the healthy way and the fast way. I've got two different tutorials, and also how to remove old fashioned color, like how I got my pink hair out of my hair and how I went to blonde so quickly. So those videos will be listed in the description box below, just to give you guys some additional information. Obviously, I started off with blonde hair. The colors that I used is my own kind of concoction. I used LaRiche Directions hair color. They are obviously a cruelty-free hair color. They don't have any peroxide or anything like that. It's just a semi permanent conditioning color. So obviously this color will fade. It's not going to fade back to blonde because the color still does lock in there, but it is a semi color, so it's going to be a lot easier to get out. These colors I purchased from an online store called pimpmyeyes.com.au. I'll list it in the description box below, but they have really, really fast shipping. And if you live in Australia, like I live in rural Australia, and I cannot get my hands on any colors like this, so that's why I order them online. So yeah, so I ordered quite a few different colors, but for the mint green, what I used was alpine green and a little bit of spring green. So basically the mixture is half a cup of conditioner, because obviously alpine green is really, really dark. So I used half a cup of conditioner, 3/4 teaspoon of alpine green, and 1/4 teaspoon of spring green. And that is what I used to get this exact color. Obviously the color is going to vary depending on what color your hair is when you put it over your hair, if you know what I mean. So if your hair is not as blonde as what I was, it's going to vary. If your blonde's lighter, this color will probably turn out a little bit more pastel. So basically what I did with mixing colors is I always use a piece of paper. Obviously my hair was not white when I started off with, so any colors you see on here are not going to be as intense when you see it on your hair. So you want to make the colors a little bit more intense, so when it's on your hair, it's going to be the right color. So this is alpine green just on its own. I then just started playing around, mixing with a few different colors until I got the right shade, which was this one here. So application, basically I applied it on dry hair. I mean, each to their own. The instructions, I'm pretty sure, say to apply it on freshly washed hair, shampooed hair, yeah. But in my personal opinion, any extra moisture in your hair, especially when you're aiming for a color like this, is going to dilute the color. So I washed my hair the day before. Obviously it was dry, and then I went away and applied it. How I apply it is using a kind of cobweb section. I go from center of my head to the back of my nape, and then from center of my head to ear to ear, and then just do a diagonal sections. The main thing when applying colors like this is make sure that you take small sections, get the color on really, really well, so it's all even. I left the color on for a few hours, just wrapped it up in cling wrap, because you know there's no real kind of processing time. It doesn't matter how long you leave it on, it's not going to damage your hair, it's just going to act as a treatment. After I washed it off, it was a little bit uneven, obviously, because a blonde hair, it can be more porous and have uneven quality of health in there. So I went through exactly the same formula and just reapplied it, and obviously this is the end result. So very, very, very happy with it. My hair feels in fantastic condition because it is like a conditioning treatment when you do these colours. And yeah, I'm just really, really happy. I just love how it's turned out. Obviously, I'm not sure how it's going to fade because I have not washed it yet since I've done it. So I'll try and keep you guys up to date. But if you watch my pink, purple and blue ombre video, I share with you guys what I do to keep my color fresh. All I basically do is just mix some in with my conditioner every time I wash my hair, so it just helps keep it fresh. That was with Manic Panic. I'm pretty sure the Laurish Directions is going to last a little bit longer than what the Manic Panic did. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. Again, check out the description box below. I'll link those other videos I mentioned down there if you want to know more about it. And yeah, love you guys. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.